Hey there, let's add and subtract some rational expressions. I have four problems here that I would like to do for you. Before we add and subtract rational expressions, we always have to have a least common denominator. And in the cases with all these x's, we should factor the denominators we have and see what we need to use in order to build this least common denominator. This first fraction has the denominator x plus 3. That's already factored. The second one has x squared plus 3x. We could factor out an x so that we have this. Now, looking at our x plus 3, looking at our x and our x plus 3, our least common denominator needs to have all of those factors in them. Now, since we have an x plus 3 here and an x plus 3 in the second fraction, I only need one x plus 3 in my least common denominator. From the first fraction to the new fraction, we have this x. So we'll take that and we'll multiply it to the x we already have. From the second fraction to the new fraction, there is no change, so there'll be no change in our numerator. I'll multiply my two x's together. I have a trinomial on top that I noticed that can factor. Factor into an x plus a 2 and an x plus a 3. And these x plus 3 factors cancel, and I'm left with final answer, x plus 2 over x. Now, as tempted as you might be to cancel these x's, you can't cancel these x's. The x on top is involved in an addition problem, and until you've taken care of that, you can't cancel. The only time you can cancel is things that you have factored, like I did this step right here. Problem number two. We're adding two problems here, two fractions here. The denominators, both of these are already factored, and they're very unique. They have absolutely nothing in common. When that happens, your least common denominator will just be those two factors multiplied together. So from our first fraction to our new fraction, you see that that 8x minus 1 is new, so we multiply that to the numerator we already have. It's important at this step that if you cancel anything that you might have attached to the top, that you're back to where you started. Don't do that because you don't want to undo what you've done. Plus x plus 3, let's see, the second fraction, this x plus 3 on the bottom is new, so we need to multiply that with the x plus 3 that we already have on top. So my third step, I'm going to distribute the 2, and I'm going to FOIL those two groups there on the end. So this will be 16x minus a 2. And then I FOIL the two x plus 3s I have there on the end. My x and my x make an x squared. I have an x and a 3, that makes a 3x. I have another 3 and an x, so that makes another 3x, so I have 6x. And then the two 3s multiply together to give me 9. I'll simplify the top by combining any like terms I can, and then I'll see if I can do any reducing factoring first. I have an x squared. I have a 16x and a 6x. I have a negative 2 and a positive 9. Looking at the trinomial there on top, I don't believe I can factor that. And since I can't factor that, I can't do any kind of reducing. Okay? Problem number 3. Here we're subtracting. Be very careful with the subtraction signs. Subtraction signs in front of fractions are like subtraction signs in front of parentheses. Any thing that you have on top, you would need to make sure you distribute that negative. If you'll do it the way I do it, I don't think you'll have any problem. Little conceit there. On the bottom of the first fraction, we have a difference of squares that we can factor into an x minus a 5 and an x plus a 5. Your least common denominator needs to be large enough to take care of both of these parentheses and this x plus 5 that you have over here. Your least common denominator needs to be these two parentheses. From our first fraction to our new fraction, there's no change, so the 3x doesn't change. Minus, from our second fraction to our new fraction, we need this x minus 5 group here. So we'll multiply that with our 2. Now be careful when you distribute that 2. You're not distributing a 2, you're distributing a negative 2. So that'll be negative 2x plus 10. We'll simplify the top. We'll look to see if we can do any kind of factoring so we can reduce. Simplify the top. We have a 3x minus a 2x. That's a single x. I cannot factor the top. I cannot reduce. Final answer. Number four. We have three fractions here. We're adding them. The three denominators, x minus 4, this is already factored. In the middle here, we have a trinomial that we could factor into two groups. X leads a negative 20 with a positive 1, a positive 5, negative 4. And on the end, we have an x plus 5, which is already factored. So your least common denominator needs to be large enough where all those factors are taken care of. I always start with the largest denominator, and then I look to make sure that all the smaller denominators are already incorporated. X minus 4, I have that. On the end here, x plus 5, I have that. So this will be my least common denominator. From the first one to the new large one, I need this x plus 5. So the x that I already have, I'll multiply with an x plus 5. I'll do that distributing in a moment. From the second fraction to the new one, there's no change. From the last one to the new one, I need this x minus 4. And then I'll simplify. This will be x squared plus 5x plus 18 plus 2x minus an 8 all over this least common denominator. Let me clean that up. I have an x squared term. I have a couple of x terms, so I'll combine those to make a new x term. I have a couple of numbers. I'll combine those to make a new number. And I can factor that top. I can factor that top into a couple of different binomials. X is leading. Let's see, a 10 with a 7. That would be a 5 and a 2. A very clever problem. The x plus 5's cancel. And that is as far as you can go. I know you might be tempted to cancel these x's, but you can't. The x on top is involved in adding with a 2. The x on the bottom is involved with subtracting a 4. And unless you can do some factoring ahead, you cannot do any kind of reducing. There you go. Hope you enjoyed that. Have a nice day. Hug you folks.